So they got telescope as well. So now Kuro gives him bonus attack range. He has basically permanent double base damage.
Oh,
right,
Cinder
now.
Man, we got the arena. Soxa looks to be dead at the start of the fight, but the RP from Seb comes on the silent, but the BKB already popped by Ally to W. There's the buyback now from Soxa as the egg forces everybody out. Seb on the run, BKB no more. I see him power off just before. Now Miracle applying some pressure to No-Tail. As this fight is very segregated. Swap onto ILTW. Still has his Sunder, but there's the Terrorize. Do they have the damage to actually burst through him? With the Sunray coming through as well, trying to heal as much as he can. But Soxa with the Bedlam, that is enough. Terrorblade is dead. Does have buyback, though. It's going to cost Sumail, though, if he's not careful. Trying to heal up through this Sunray, but it's not going to happen. A triple kill for Miracle, as he is just going ham right now. Fully healthy as well. With that Spell Prism in his inventory, Soxa gets off the Yules for now. Seb on the sideline. He cannot do anything with this Cold Snap Spirit Vessel combination. Ultra kill for Miracle. He's looking for more, but now he's a little bit low. Soxa gets off the Shadow Realm, but Miracle's gonna live for now. Looks like he's gonna be okay. Looking for No-Tail on the sideline now. Goes up to the high ground. He wants his Rampage Cinder Man. I don't know if it's too late. He gets it. Rampage for freaking Miracle. He's now inside the arena. The triple meatball surprise as Sumail has to wave for him to safety. Only he and Hoodwink are alive, but maybe not for long. This could be a dieback onto Thompson, and it is just that. A double Rampage for Miracle.
On the Reflect. 60 seconds, no Poppy against Secret Court in a situation where they're trying to defend with a... Oh, there's the combo, oh, baby! The Dream Coil into the kick! He's out, they're calling it. Secret's had enough of this one. GG is called as Nygma will take...
He epied the floor.
Well, the floor's dead, I guess. Secret, they've got to find the IO. They're going to be able to jump over, get the grab on the mine, control the setups there with the Remnant. They get the vacuum. Oh, the power strike. Oh, there's the combo, baby. There's the combo onto the four of them as they take down three. Miracle's not done yet. He's running down Matu. Matu and Yapsil, they've got to get out of there. As there we have it. As you were saying before, these points in the vacuum, the setups there from Mind Control.
Oh,
Enigma
my God.
With a beautiful turnaround. They don't need.
That's true.
Yeah, that's definitely how math works. Miracle Aegis has been consumed by Roshan himself. Now, here's the real lore question. We're going to wait for Mickey to get destroyed by Miracle. But Insania is there with the save. Insania will likely die as a result of this. Indeed, that is the case. Now, the question is, can Miracle go through this false promise? It doesn't matter! Jesus, horse! Just cleave off those creeps. Thank you, Miracle. This game is not even remotely close.
Good God. Be out here in this team fight as Mind Control is able to surge in, take down Thompson. Seb is trying to get back in here.
But it puts him into the GH!
Oh, no! It's straight into the cog, so that TP ain't gonna work, and it will fall.
On the front line, slowing down ILTW as much as possible. Gotta be careful of that buildup of damage, though. Mickey getting bashed up, he couldn't get off the Guardian Angel. He ends up falling. Quaifa's too low to be able to get the stomp. Now the jump in from Kuro, looking to be able to hold these heroes in place, but Sumail managed to get away as the Dark Willow turns back into his form. Doesn't have the Shadow Realm just yet. They're gonna reset a little bit here. Mickey with his buyback immediately has to guard the Angel for fear of getting bashed up again. But there goes the Tornado. Quaifa managed to intercept with a two-man stomp. Mickey slowed down to a crawl as he tries to get out of these tree brambles. There goes the Sumail damage. But here comes the Cataclysm. Oh, the cookie! He managed to get Sumail partially out of the way of that. They turn around and kill the Dragon Knight. Now Sumail bashed up with the heal coming through. Sumail trying to get out, but he doesn't have anything. The Adaptive Strike, the Strength Board pushes him back by LTW. Now an onslaught of damage coming out from Sumail, but relocate away. He turns toward the Miracle instead. ILTW's going back in. He actually managed to kill the Centaur. Can he kill Sumail? Sumail out of mana turns into the Dark Will, but there's no health there. He dies. Mickey's up next. A die back for him. He comes back as the Morphling, but he does not have Taiga anymore. He can't turn into the Dark Willow.
Oh my God, it's not the damage done that's counting in these fights, Cap, it's the healing done. Double Holy Lock it once again on both Nygma supports.
They're just spamming it on the PA. And they are right in front of the fountain.
And the Blink Dagger now available on a Dragonite. He's to the top lane. Nice dodge.
A dodge on the finger.
When you have a lineup like this and you go from the laning stage,
Da Vinci want to fight this without a lifestealer?
Not a Thibbert, though.
They're going on a Timbersaw. And now the turnaround jump with the Supernova. They're in the arena, but the leader, she's nearly dead. A bit of a wall charge there on the Yules into the air. Miracle still standing strong. GH down, though the egg was focused. Miracle needs to get out now. Mind Control looking for the turnaround. Back onto DY. Blows through the ET. Old 11 and P1W, they're stunned. And Miracle,
the finger.
He's still alive. Kuro's finger secures the fight.
The Fairy fires up, and with the TP over from Sax, the GH won't move in anymore. Thompson's going to be fine.
The two games I believe that I saw, Miracle does have to be a little bit careful. Stun.
Oh.
Will connect.
Oh, hello.
Roll is off, but might still just go down.
He's
the
toss.
He's
in the top. Oh, it's closed. Oh, oh, my goodness.
He gets him.
We're getting these moves already here.
Keeps that spot going. Slark. Pretty deep dive here. Again, playing around these long cooldown ultimates. RTW taking Mind Control low, but the silence onto the Omni Knight and Miracle. Nice false promise there. Keeps No Tail alive, so the heals will keep coming. They need to get RTW out, though, as we spirit siphoning through them all. Purification comes from No Tail. And we? He's moved up the high ground. He's one versus four, but the Yule Scepter up the Fortune's End down. Kicked away. GH saves the day and now rolls away. Oh my god, Nygma, really? Playing it incredibly tight there as Miracle poking, prodding, and getting the jump onto Saxa. Finds the initiation he needs. Gush towards Thompson. Got strength though. Sven wants in. Jumps forward towards the Miracle PA, but they've got the Yules up into the air, and now the Will-O-Wisp comes. Dragging both of them inside, and Seb's annihilated. Weehar's godlike. RTW gonna run away. An arrow will stop the advance of Nygma now. Yeah, that late game potential and the scaling from the Spectre. You want to be taking her out very early on, but given a pretty free game there, 11,000 net worth as they catch up Palos. Yules and the Remnant not tagging Miracle. Lightstrike array towards Kuroki, but they heal once again from GH. They buy so much time and extend these fights that Palos dies twice. Now move in with Nico, but look at the damage from RTW shredding through this Execration side, and the spear from Mind Control secures once more the BDZ Lina, while RR is left stranded. The borrowed time will only delay the inevitable death of the Abaddon. MC's in once again, and a triple kill for the Spectre.
It's just too much damage, too much control coming out from Team Nygma. Cold Embrace used multiple times. They actually caught misclick. Never mind.
On the outs here, but not ones to go down without a fight. They've got a five-man smoke up and play to see if they can turn this game around, despite the fact that ILTW has an Aegis.
And alt.
GPK.
They're gonna break in. Mind Control fights the initiation first with double cataclysm right again. That's GPK down. Kingslayer dead as well. An RP that was stolen earlier by GH for style points to be able to kill DM. That utter trouncing. Virtus Pro just got worked by Nygma.
I am not sure, as we watch Save go down as well, how you're supposed to team fight into 20 Sunstrikes.
People just very clearly.
Oh, geez.
They almost booped noses there, my goodness.
They kind of did. Oh, my, that was...
right on the cusp there.
Look at that.
Yeah, look at this.
Look at this pad. Look at how sneaky they're being.
Nine.
This is insane. Nine's very close to his tower, though. That's a tough one to get. They're playing
Yeah, but they're waiting. They're hoping that Nine's gonna...
He's gonna stay. Is he gonna step back? They're waiting at the wings.
Come hither, my child.
Oh, is he gonna get caught here? It looks
All
like
right,
he is.
That's gonna be the jump, the brambles, everything getting used on Nine. And Mind Control's gonna be off to a really nice start.
That they could take away the gem on the Dark Willow, take Roshan for themselves. And then that Ursa line runs out of steam. Nightfall moving in, breaks the smoke. Haunts immediately going out. They got the vision. Mind Control's gonna go for DM. Once again, the Finger of Death, the same combo. They killed them before, we'll kill them now. Kingslayer is out. They do have the Ice Blast. That's going out, but it's on a dead curl.
He
managed
to
use the RP, and GH turns it right back around. But at the same time, the Ursa managed to dodge that one. GPK with his BKB out. Didn't take any damage during that time. He's hunting out Miracle in the trees right now. Miracle hiding away, hoping that he isn't found. Throws out the Deafening Blast. They see him now. The Terrorize goes out. Save. He's moving into position to try and catch out the Invoker, but he's into a creep wave. They do have the Shadow Realm. Can he put out enough damage? The Impale looking to be able to stop him. GPK's after him. And in the last shot, he blinks away from it. He manages to get out. Meanwhile, ILTW has killed the Ursa. There's nothing left on the Virtus Pro side. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and a five-man down from Virtus Pro. Nygma with a loud scream just wiped.
Insania gets there.
The team too.
The relocate's gonna come in. ILTW. They're gonna go for Insania. Cookie into the tier 2 tower, but ILTW is showing he is not afraid of diving heroes. Still gone in for it, and it looks like Mickey's not able to get a heal because Dragon tailed up. Now they're actually gonna get the EMP. This may burn him out. They're gonna use the ultimate, and Curl gives the walk away. That's going to be two dead on the side of Liquid. Samael should be fine thanks to Morph's strength.
But look at this, already into the pit there. Really? Like so fast. Oh my god, this is insane.
Taiga knows, but Taiga, and he can terrorize. He's going to do it now. They pop the Enrage, though, so ILTW is not afraid of anything the Stark Willow does. In fact, he's actually going to try and challenge him. They do have Koifa coming in here, but oh no! Taiga died too quickly for that. They're going to go for GH instead. Insania does have the ultimate. He's going to go for the cookie first, but now that just lines him up for the two-man tornado EMP. Liquid are being outplayed. They're being outmaneuvered, and they are just flat out dying.
Definitely do some damage to Roshan as now the counter smoke from Team Nygma.
Wrap around. Okay.
Yep, into the enemy triangle. ILTW, of course, doesn't have the Blink Dagger, but Mind Control does. And with that Sunray, Yapzor gets deleted by Miracle. ILTW technically gets the credit for that kill, but in the meantime, Mind Control again just getting bursted down right now. Buyback onto the Witch Doctor, but it's going to cost them Enchantress as well. So a 3-for-nothing as Mind Control somehow surviving. Matu just running around with that Alchemist on his head. They can't do anything about it. A triple kill for Miracle.
Oh, Miracle? Oh, okay. Well,
I'm not quite sure what that was for no kill, but a little bit of it. Okay, still gets the snake, but there's no real follow-up to it. Zed is just in right now, and maybe he's overextended himself. They're going to jump onto him, throw out the magic damage. Disruption does help him for a second. Miracle's got to be careful. Winter's Curse going down. It's going to be able to buy the Timbersaw a little bit of time to be able to work with here. The tomb is out. The zombies are building up, and Seb is not finding the trees to be able to connect to right now, but Samael is standing and putting out the damage. Thompson, though, not able to have the same kind of survivability. They are picking apart the cores of OG right now and ignoring the Medusa. Mind Control, two-man Burrow Strike once again. Finding these disables. No Tail putting ILTW down into low ground, but this is a one fight for Nygma. If anything, ILTW wants to be able to pursue these heroes as, once again, a two-man Burrow Strike for Mind Control. This guy has totally disrupted anything that OG wanted to do in that fight. Just beautiful.
He's an Alchemist, so maybe.
Maybe if you, yeah, enough gold to buy a Pudge, perhaps, as Miracle gets the trap up. But the Zai set up with the arena into the spear. Will they be able to take him out with that Pulse Nova going to work on him? In the meantime, yeah, he's actually going to stay alive with the Refraction on the other side now. And there's the big combo from Mind Control. The choppity chop on two, make it three. Yapzor will be the fourth. Big turnaround for Team Nygma.